And welcome. This is Tim Heffern along with Colin Leiter calling the action in tonight's Midwest Intercollegiate Volleyball Association matchup between the upcoming Mercyhurst College Lakers and the IPFW Mastodons. We will break four messages at this time.
Since you graduated from college, we haven't seen too much of you.
We know you've been very busy climbing the ladder of success.
We've been watching you on your way up,
and we've enjoyed seeing you put your degree to work.
Now, how about sharing your time with us?
Your expertise would come in handy, too.
You can reconnect with your alma mater through your alumni association.
It's time for you to come back to your campus.
Call your alumni office today.
Hi, Puddin.
Oh, you're so cute. I don't have shoes.
Oh, if you are gorgeous. Noreen. Talk to me. Come on, you can do it.
Get the keys. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
Everybody, we're about ready to get to the announcements here. And here come the house announcers' introductions for tonight's lineup.
At this time, I'd like to announce the starting lineups, beginning with Mercyhurst College. Beginning with number one, Ahmad Omerhodzic. Number two, Andrew Mahaven. Number seven, Greg Beato. Number nine, Matt Tamburino. Number 10, Jim Zorn. And captain number 15, Adam Tokesh. The Lakers are coached by Mr. Craig Davick. And now the starters for your IPFW Mastodons. And number one, Justin Luna. Captain number five, Ricardo Soler. Number seven, Ryan Perrott. Number 10, Chris Gislin. Number 11, Mike Cummings. And number 12, Javier Escobar. The head coach for the Mastodons is Arnie Ball and assisted by Mark Frankie, Lisa Horman, Roger Horman, and Dave Schmidlin.
This evening's IPFW men's volleyball match on Channel 6 is brought to you in part by Fujifilm USA. By the Chestnut Group, Incorporated, and by Farm Bureau Insurance. Yeah, well, Colin, what do we have in store for us tonight?
Tonight's match could be pretty exciting as far as how IPFW plays. With all the sickness going around, if you've noticed during the announcements of the starting lineups, Justin Luna is in place of Hector Soto, who has not practiced all week. He is available. Coach Ball said he is available if needed, but hopefully Justin Luna, who has been a force off the bench in recent matches, is going to get a chance to start.
Yeah, that's an unusual spot for him. He's very good at coming in off the bench, according to Coach Ball, and hasn't been necessarily the star starter, but he's used to coming off the bench. Our first referee, Dane Sines, takes the stand as Brian Moore, the second official, checks the lineups. And we're about ready to start our first service.
Mercyhurst comes in at 8-3. They just lost a three-game close match to Ohio State the other night, so they're ready to play.
Chris with a sidewinder jumper up in the sets outside to the lefty, the opposite. Beautiful dig by Luna. That's what you get by with a ball control of Luna's. Everybody, I think, remembers that incredible coverage dig that won that Loyola match.
And Ricardo Soler with the tip kill as the opposite for First it hurts.
And there's that sidewind jumper. It looks like it's going to be a straight jumper, but it actually has side spin on it, and it curves, fools the passer. And the if you notice, the right back player, their setter, is coming out of the right back, which complicates the situation. There's a bump set to the middle, which is highly unusual. Off the block, out of bounds, Justin Luna.
Justin Luna's coming in, playing well. So far, no butterflies.
That's the key for him, is if he can get a couple good swings in and if he can get a couple good passes in. He's already got a nice dig. Working number 10 over is IPFW. He hits a nice cross-court angle around a solid double block.
And that was one of the shots that Coach Ball talked about in his pregame meeting. He comes and hits the ball across court from that line or that position.
Here we go, back to the action. Nice roll shot by the Hobbs. It is out of bounds as they try to cover that play. Yeah, we should mention, Colin, who the big heavy hands are for Mercyhurst.
Well, they're led by Jim Zorn.
That ball's down, looked like a dig, but it was hit the floor first.
Jim Zorn averages 4.4 kills a game, so he gets quite a few sets out there.
Ricky with a marginal pass back set to Javi. It's a beautiful set. That ball goes off the middle back to the wall, trying to hit those new clocks we just put up on the wall. Didn't quite clip them, though.
Coach Ball said this team plays a lot of defense, so it's good to see our hitters get off to a good quick start.
Oh, there's a block by Justin Luna. Diving in, totally roofs him.
Hitter thought he had a hole in the block, and Justin reached in, just like you diagram it, just like you teach it.
That ball's into the net. I think that's kind of a standard for Mike Cummings, that first serve in, that second serve into the net.
He struggles with that second one.
There we go, Justin with a nice pass. Pipe set, nice dig. That's the ball control you're gonna get out of Mercyhurst. The cross, and it's successful as our middle held their middle blocker, opening up the lanes for Javi to get an easy kill. There we go again, they're picking on Justin. That ball is hit in. Ball's called in as our players thought it was out.
Yeah. Ricardo Solar got a little too far into the court, couldn't make the dig.
At this point, the score is 4-0 IPFW. They're on the attack again, and Javier Escobar out of the back row, the D position scores.
Javier's really picking it up this match. He came out off the bench on fire.
There's a nice jumper down the line by Luna. They run the middle, it's blocked well. Parrot all over that baby. And that might help out the whole feel of the match for the Dons if they can stifle their middle.
IPFW has really struggled stopping other teams' middles. That's a good sign for us to come out and block that first one.
There goes Justin again, very consistent on his serve. Oh, there's a solid block, and it just squeaks through the arms of Ryan. And boy, that was a nice block. Yeah. We smoked that out.
Blockers were shoulder to shoulder that time. It just squeaked between their arms.
There they go with an easy serve and an easy pass. And we've got a green set. It's blocked. Justin with the hands out to Ricky. Ricky gets a Drano down the middle side of the blocker. Didn't get over the net. And the ball runs down between his body and the net. Call that a Drano.
Great job of Justin realizing that Chris Gislin, the setter, was playing that first ball. Someone had to step in and set.
Ryan to serve here at 5-0 Dons. That ball barely makes the bottom of the net. Just going for a little much when maybe you don't have to go for that much. And here we go with a broken play for the Dons. That ball is hit out of bounds again, trying for too much. When you don't have to, just keep the ball in play. So that gets the Lakers on the board at 1-5. Justin with a nice pass. We run middle, it's mishit. Misses the block, that'll be point two.
Mike Cummings got a little bit tight to the net. The set was behind him and he couldn't hit it down.
Here we go again, and there's another ice pass by Justin. He's certainly playing well. That sets off the net, and the ball is down. Goes underneath the net. That's considered out of bounds.
As you can see, Mercyhurst digs a lot of balls. They're going to be scrambling a lot.
Here we go, Chris Gislin back with his jumper. He gets an ace serve. We might have a timeout by the Lakers. I don't know. Are they just making an adjustment over there? They're trying to make an adjustment in their serve reception pattern, getting the setter closer to the net. Beautiful shot. Oh, it just touches the net. Exactly what they're aiming for. They're trying to disrupt that setter penetrating from the back row.
Anything to take them out of their offense. Just a little bit of hesitation on the part of the setter helps.
And there's a nice serve by the Lakers, but a better set by a tall setter. That's what the tall setter can bring you.
Great job of bringing it back, and a good job of Mike Cummings being up there ready to hit it.
Yeah, that's something that, Colin, you and I couldn't provide Arnie with, was that tall setter. And we have a question
even
here, some kind
was,
of a question.
No one was going to get the
sure,
ball, so.
What the question.
Yes, you can.
I thought maybe it was a quick whistle because this year the rules have changed and the foot, playing it off the foot, is legal.
And here we go. Craig is still, their coach is still up and contesting the play while the top official is trying to signal for the serve. He does now. Jump floater by Ricky. Nice pass, however. They run their middle and we get a Drano. No, it's not a Drano. The ball never made it over the net. Point for the Dons.
Hit Mike Cummings almost in the chest on that. Trying to hit it two straight down.
Another jump floater. No, it's not a jump floater. It's a spinner. And there is a shot through Justin's hands. Side out. 7-2 in favor of the Dons at this point. And Colin, I think we look in pretty good shape.
We're looking pretty well right now.
Beautiful pass on target.
Oh!
And that's what you get with a perfect pass. Justin Luna has come in, taken over Hector's spot. Hector being ill this week with strep throat. Justin has just come in and done a fantastic job so far at this outside hitter position. Here we go with a net on somebody. We're not sure who it is.
Justin or Ryan, but it was on IPFW nonetheless.
Beautiful set. That is just a great set by Chris Gislin to back set that ball with no block up. Just pounds away.
That time the block.
There's the quick, looks like it's going to be a floater serve by Javi, but he whips into a quick jumper out of it, and he hits a quick jumper out of bounds.
Looked like he played a ball that was out of bounds. He was standing on the back line and played it at his waist. Somebody's got to talk to him, tell him that ball's out.
7-2 still the score here as Justin's still putting that ball on target. He's got a double block, so he tries to cut it too fine, hits it out of bounds.
That's went point for, number two.
Yeah, just went
point
for a little
three.
Too much there,
yeah.
I think. 7-3, that's an overpass as Chris Gislin just couldn't handle it. Here we go. Don seemed to be falling apart at this point, making unforced errors. Just need to get back into a rhythm here. The jumper is into the net to help out the Dons as Justin will go back to serve here. And we all know, knock, knock on wood, that Justin's very consistent at serving.
He's come in to serve many times at the end of the match.
Another nice serve. It's outside, and that ball's pounded to the ground. I think Chris Gislin gave him a little too much line that time.
Jim Zorn's their top hitter. You got to get out there on him.
And here we go again with the Lakers asking for something. We're not sure what it is. Looks like Chris Gislin is bleeding. He's bleeding, so we will have some kind of an injury timeout now with
30
seconds. With the blood rule in effect. Yeah. They'll have to stop that bleeding or he won't be able to continue.
Let
play go on, and he shouldn't be wiping it on his uniform because if they see it on his uniform, then they're going to make him change that uniform. And here we go again. It's just not stopped bleeding here. So they're gonna force a timeout on IPFW's part. And we will be right back after these messages.
Check it out.
The campus has it all.
Learning, a working, a playing, just do it. It's a cool place. Call now. Go to work, go to school, go ahead.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome. This is Tim Heffern along with Colin Leiter. We're in the middle of the first game. It's 7-4 to the Dons' advantage. Timeout was forced upon the Dons as we had a blood problem off of Chris Gislin's elbow. Trainer Mike Gale has taken care of the situation with a major bandage happening on that left arm of his as we're ready to play.
Ahmed Omerhodzic to serve for the Lakers.
We're off again. Justin's coming up with a pass here. It's outside to Ricky. He goes for it. It's blocked. It's up. Ricky brings it back into play. We've got to give him the free ball. Chris is way deep. They play it. It's on target. Big old block. We've got it up. Chris Gislin to the Hobbs out of the D position. He loves that shot. It's going out of bounds, and they try to save it, but don't.
Great job of hustle by the Dons right there. Keep that ball alive, make some good sets.
Boy, that's a nice rally coming out of a timeout.
Javier puts the ball away from the back row.
Ryan to serve. Let's see if he can get this one going in there. He's got it going long this time. Just what you don't need after you take all that work to get a side out.
And he's got to find a happy medium. Last one was in the net. This one was long.
Let's the Lakers have another shot at it as Ricky with a beautiful pass. Nice block, but a great pickup, and Ricky goes for it and hits it into the net.
Great job of coverage on the first play.
That'll be a point for the Lakers. Don struggling to find a rhythm here right now. They got a nice short serve. Mike Cummings handles it well. There's the middle shot. He doesn't hit where he should. Ball is out of bounds. They're asking for the touch. They will not get it. They will not get the touch. Side out for the Dons.
Dons have stalled here at 7. They need to get something going.
Gislin with his jumper. A new person. He picks on a new person, and we've got an ace.
They haven't quite figured out this side spin serve of Gislin's.
There it is again. Takes them out of their offense as they just got to set the back row. It's a tip. Ricky with a nice play and Haas with a set to the middle. Just setting it too tight because only one blocker up on our folks. And the one blocker's handling them. There's no way that should happen.
No. They're a little too tight. Got to get back so you can hit your angles.
Because it's there. They got the one-on-one they want. They're just not putting the ball away. 8-5 is the score at this point. Beautiful pass, and there's another block by the Lakers. They've just got Mike Cummings' number right now. Being fairly ineffective out of the middle, just blasting away at the same angle. He's not hitting angles, he's hitting it straight ahead into the block.
They're not fooling anybody with their set selection right now.
Here we go with another perfect pass. It's not for the lack of passing, I'll tell you that. We passed the ball on the money. There goes the combination play. Why they jumped with Mike Cummings again, I'm not sure. Usually they'll go away from that person. There we go with a nice jump floater. Keeps them way out of system. That ball is out by a very small margin.
Good job of Ricky of listening to his teammates, knowing where that out of bounds is.
9-6, here we go with the jump. Spinner, he does a nice job of changing that up, and you really can't tell until after he hits it, as we've got a net violation on the Dons.
Mercyhurst has a couple players that aren't big hitters, but they know how to tool the block. You're going to see that off the block a lot tonight.
Short serve. Looks like the Lakers have tried that a few times now. Going for the short serve. That ball is off the block. Not only that, it's inbounds. We've got a substitution. Brian Harris shall enter the game for Mike Cummings. I'd say that's a pretty good idea.
That's a good job. Mike's been struggling with his serves. Get our serving specialist to come in. See if we can run a couple points here.
That's right. This is a kind of a sticky point in the game. Even though we're ahead 9-6, it's anybody's game at this point. And when you get a nice serve like that to take them out of their offense, you can get a swing like that, get a kill and a point like that. That's what you want to do to break free from that sticky point and dominate that game. We're up 10-6. We're on a roll.
Mercyhurst has a short front line right here. We got to take advantage of it.
Big old block, it's up. Javi with a nice play. Ricky's going to set it outside. We've got a nice shot at this. Triple block. It's out of bounds. Off the block. They go with a triple block.
Great job of Javi coming down with the ball off the block, locating the ball and making a play on it.
And the Lakers from Mercyhurst have called a timeout here at 11-6, trying to thwart that momentum the IPFW Macedons have built. We will be back after these messages.
College Cable Access Program Guide provides information about our programming, including IPFW Sports Telecast. To receive your free Channel 6 program guide, send your name, address, and zip code to Channel 6 at IPFW, 2101 East Coliseum Boulevard, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46805. Or call us at 481-6000 or email us at channel6@ipfw.edu.
And here we go out of the timeout, ready to serve for the Dons. Ryan Harris still on the roll here at 11-6. He goes for a short serve. They get a nice set to the middle, and I think Perot should have maybe smelled that out a little better.
Didn't get his hands over. Coach Ball's yelling at him for it. He's got to get those hands up and over quickly.
So here we go again, and that ball's in. Javi makes a nice pass. Oh, there's a great shot. Justin Luna, he's on balance that time, going around the double block.
He was a little wide with that shot earlier, but this time he nailed it down.
Javi with his jumper, he's got a spinner going this time. It is just out of bounds.
Adam Tokash back to serve for the Lakers.
Ball's in, another nice pass by Justin. It's fooling everybody, let me tell you. Tell you, when you got ball control like that, the Dons are hard to beat.
They've got so many weapons, and they're trying to commit on that middle block, middle hitter. We're getting one-on-one on the outside.
Justin with a beautiful serve, takes him out of their offense. It's an overpass, and Ricky gets a kill.
Don't know why the setter didn't go up and try to block that one. It looks like he's front row. He stood and watched Ricky hit it.
Here we go, he's smoking his jumper. Takes them out of their middle offense again, and that ball is in. I don't know. Looked kind of fishy to me, but they'll take it. It's 12-6 in favor of the Dons.
We need to move our block a little bit more inside, giving them too much of a big angle to hit inside.
That ball is out of bounds. Just catches a wind current and takes off. Mike Cummings back in the game for Brian Harris. Great job by Brian Harris to move us forward.
A couple big serves back there. Got us off the nine spot.
Ryan's going to serve one in this game. He does. He gets one in. Takes him out of their offense. Zorn is going to get roofed.
Great job of Mike Cummings. Seeing him trying to hit that cross-court angle, he just reached in there and blocked it back on him.
Didn't have much choice on that. That ball was set a little tight. And with those two big guys over there blocking, any trap set is pretty much terminated. That ball is out of bounds. However, the Dons are in the net. Side out for the Lakers again. The Dons get another point out of the deal. It's 13-6 at this point. Oh, there's a shaky pass by Ricky. Great set, however, by Chris Gislin. Ricky makes up for it with a nice kill through the double block.
After a bad pass like that, he's got to make up for it with a big hit.
I don't think we'll put that one in the playbook, huh?
Oh.
And the spinner! Guess what? It's an ace.
They're really picking on that middle back there. Ahmad Omar Hadzik.
It's a shocker, but the Dons are going for it here. I believe they are going to try to slow it down with a substitution. Defensive sub at this point. I don't think that's going to much matter as the Dons fans are on their feet here, going for it, cheering them on. Chris Gislin with a spinner. It's in. It's a middle attack. It's not over the net. That's a point and game for the Dons.
Great job of Mike Cummings being up on the block, taking the angle away, making him try to hit a shot that it was not possible to hit, and it ended up in the net.
Exactly. I think maybe Coach Franke told him that in that rotation, possibly, he's the one who's going to get set, so let's just commit with him, because that's what it sure looked like to us.
We'll be right back for more MIVA volleyball action right after this.
Team spirit is alive and well at IPFW. That's because IPFW has established itself as an athletic power, not only regionally, but nationally. With 11 major sports, IPFW offers talented student athletes great opportunities. Success and support of IPFW athletics comes solely from the fans, students, faculty, alumni, and the prestigious Royal Dons Club. The Royal Dons Athletic Club has over 500 members who financially support IPFW athletics, enabling the university to provide scholarships to deserving athletes. Members will receive one or all of the following: season passes to all sporting events, special seating, hospitality room, plus Royal Dons apparel and gifts. Be a part of the winning tradition. Join the Royal Dons Club. We need your support. Call IPFW Athletics. Get into the team spirit.
The IPFW Omnibus Lecture Series proudly welcomes speaker Douglas Wilder, former presidential candidate and first black governor in U.S. history, Thursday, February 19th at 7:30 p.m. in the Wall Ballroom, sponsored by News Channel 15.
Hi, I'm Edward James Olmos. On the streets of Fort Wayne, there's a battle going on. It's about kids fighting kids and families fighting families. Our youth are struggling to survive. Without positive alternatives to gangs, drugs, and violence, many will end up incarcerated or dead. You can make a difference by supporting the Multicultural Youth Advisory on Gangs and its programs. They provide alternatives for youth. Together, we can stop the violence and increase the peace. To learn how you can make a difference in the lives of youth, please call.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome. This is Tim Affron along with Colin Leiter again. We're in between games as the Dons win the first one, 15-6. What do we see in the stats here, Colin?
Well, they had a couple players that hit a good percentage. Two players hit 500, one player hit 800. The only problem is they didn't hit that many balls. One with two for four, and two for four, they're not getting that many swings.
We almost have twice as many assists as they do, and the big difference, I think, that the surprise of the match is that Lakers are known for defense, and they only had three digs that game.
And IPFW had 11, so we're playing some good defense. And we're putting the ball away when we need to.
That in combination with us out blocking them 4-1, I'd say that's going to pretty much terminate a team that is a little more athletic than the other team. I think the key, obvious key for Mercyhurst, as it was for Clark last week, is to try to out ball control us, out dig us, put us on the defensive by serving tough. Haven't seen very tough serves out of the Lakers yet.
Their serve, except for a couple jump serves, their serves have been really weak, and we've been able to pass it pretty well.
IPFW Men's Volleyball on Channel 6 is brought to you in part by Fujifilm USA, the Chestnut Group, and the Farm Bureau Insurance Company.
Let's see if the Lakers can start off this game 2 with a tougher serve. Take IPFW out of their offense.
And here we go. Ricky, he's on target with his pass, and that's going for the pineapple as Chris is into the net on his pineapple attempt.
Good Good start for the Lakers. Let's see if IPFW can break their momentum.
Going for the short serve as Justin handles it. It's out to Ricky. Double block. That ball is in. Here's the defense of Mercyhurst. Here we go again. And that's a smoking hit down the line by Solaire.
Great play by Adam Tokas of the Lakers. That shot by Ricky caught him by surprise, and he still got it up.
Here we go with Chris again serving. Down the line this time as he's been going cross court the entire first game. Shocks everybody, including me, by going down the line.
Trying to serve into traffic here.
There it is again down the line. Gosh, they just keep them surprised. And this time, Mike Cummings makes a huge error because the setter's coming out of the back row and he jumps with a setter.
Setter cannot attack the ball above the net, so there's no reason for him to jump.
There we go with the cross play. They had double block on it, but it didn't matter as that ball slid past the blockers for an easy cross court kill.
Ricky's come out fired up this game. He's really hitting the ball well, and he's hitting the ball hard.
And there's the jump floater. Nice one. They set it outside. They got an easy shot. Perrott sticks his nose in there. Gets a great dig. And off the block is Escobar for a point.
Ties the ball game up. Great dig by Ryan Perrott there. Seeing the ball and stepping right into the hole between the block.
That ball's short into the net. You know, that's what Ryan's known for, I think, more than anything, is his ability to play some serious defense.
He plays very good defense for a middle in the back row.
2-1's the score in favor of the Dons at this point. Here's a slide set to the Dons. They smoke it out, get another block on it. Oh, beautiful roll shot to take them out of their offense. They'll just have to roll that in for the Dons. Here we go with an offense again. Big hit. It is saved. No, just couldn't get it over the net. Ball's down, another side out for the Dons. Scrappy play, however, for the Lakers.
It's what the Lakers are known for, keeping that ball alive, making you earn your points and your side outs.
Here we go with a nice serve. That ball is down with a nice shot across the body, catching this one off guard.
Setter really slowed that set up a little bit, pretty close.
He pretty much caught that one and threw it back up, it looked like. There's the option, the second option for the Dons. Very different style and setting, I think. Chris has much quicker hands. Tries to make the play go faster. There's a nice tip by the Lakers setter.
Fundamental mistake by the Dons, forgetting that the setter's in the front row. They got to call it out and get a blocker up on him.
Yeah, great shot. Here we go, back into it of the Dons. Justin gets blocked that time as he tries to go down the line. Trying to pick on the setter he was, but it just didn't work.
Setter's one of their weak spots. They're outside hitters. Their middles are pretty strong blockers.
Here we go. Looks like the Lakers are in this one a little more than they were in the last game. That's an out-of-system play by the Dons. They roll it in. And they go back row. It's in. Nice dig. Here goes Ricky. To the setter. Gislin gets one off the block. Javi sets it outside for Luna. He goes, it's saved again. There's a knuckle up. Justin rolls it in. They got Lakers got an offense. They go with a shot out of bounds. They ask for a touch. No touch. Side out for the Dons. Big play, Colin.
Great job of both teams getting the ball in play. Getting hard shots, making some defense. Last team to make an error.
Justin with his jumper, it's on target, and that shot's in. Nice spot by the Lakers. Tough to defend that one. There's a short serve, Ricky handles it well. That set's way too low, easy block for the Lakers.
Ryan had no place to go with it.
There's a Christmas present. Here we go again as it's another nice pass, and that ball is played up. They're asking for the double, and they're not going to get it. That should have been a double hit contact as it was played off his head and then played off his hand. Two separate attempts. They're not calling it, however.
Could have had his back to the up official.
Johns will go back to serve. It's played. It's in. It's off the block, and the block is in the net. Mike Cummings in the net again. Mike struggled this match so far.
He's had a couple plays, but he's got to put a string of them together here.
And there's another nice pass by the Dons. Inside cross. Read well by Lakers. They go cross court, and there's a big old hit. Kill point for the Lakers. They're up 4-2. Taking some momentum this game.
Ricky's got to hit that ball. Get a one blocker up there.
Rip it and rip it. There's the center tip. It's Redwell. Back row to Hobby. Goes through the block. Broken play by the Dons, but they make it work.
Good job of Justin stepping in there, and Hobby calling for the ball.
Gislin, we could use a couple of his serves at this point. He goes down the line again. They can't handle it.
He had some heat on that one. That one was moving.
Here we go.
Coach Stavik making some adjustments in his lineup.
Goes down the line again. Nice pass this time. They try to set middle. They miss. It goes over the net. Back set one-on-one. It's blocked. It's saved. Set outside. It's called a lift. I don't think Ryan was in quite position to try to make the set he made.
No, he's got to realize that he's a middle hitter and not a setter.
And there we go. We're back in play again. We run in a back cross. Oh, he hits it out of bounds with
one
no
on
block.
Nobody. One on nobody. Great choice by Chris Gislin.
And what happened was Ricky faked like he's going inside cross, takes a blocker that way, and comes back outside. So he had one on nobody. Hit it out of bounds. Ricky gets a one-on-one this time. It's off the block, out of bounds. Maybe he does better against the block.
He's got to have somebody up there so he can have a target.
Got to have a target. He doesn't have a target. He's in trouble. There's the jump floater down the line. A misplay. It's outside to Zorn. He swings. He hits. Great dig by Parrott again. Justin with a swing at it, and it just... I think it hit the net and the blocker at the same time went down. Brock making some nice defensive plays for the Dons tonight. 5-3 is a score in favor of the Lakers. Justin with a beautiful set. Hobby with a tip roll kind of thing, with Zorn smokes that out with an easy block kill.
Zorn's got some hops up there, so he can get up. You gotta hit that roll shot over it.
6-3 is the score right now. Cummings with one through the block here. Gets the side out. I think we've just got to have a better middle attack at this point, because we really are passing the ball well, and they're not really having to commit with our middle, so they're getting a nice double block on our outsides.
We've really got to mix it up.
That's a tight ball, and that's blocked out of bounds. No, they're in the net before the ball goes out of bounds, and that's the correct call. That ball's still live as long as it doesn't hit the ground. And it's it, and the hitter is in the net on that tight set. Cummings with a nice serve. Takes him out of their offense. Back row hit. It's off the block. Free ball in effect. Justin with a smoker out of bounds over our heads. That's a nice hit by Justin.
It all starts with great defense in the back row. Nice block up, playing the ball off the block on target.
5-6 as the Dons are rallying here at this point. Nice pass again by the Lakers. They get one-on-one. It's off the hands, out of bounds.
Justin was a little bit early on that. Gave the hitter a target to hit at. He went up and got tooled.
And we're in play again here. D hit for Ricky. Late blocker. Zorn reaches out. It goes off his hands, out of bounds. Hobby way back there for his jump floater. It's an average one as it's a perfect pass. Cross, double block up. Ricky digs it. Out of bounds, however.
Ricky was pretty close to out of bounds. I don't know if that ball was in to begin with.
That's pretty close. If you're standing on the line, you know, it's tough to tell. Happens pretty quickly. Zorn serves short. Ricky handles it. That ball's outside to Luna. He's blocked, and terrible coverage by the Dons as they all look at each other. That ball is pretty easy to play up if you're a willing participant there.
The Lakers have a couple good blockers for middles.
This looks like a tough rotation for the Dons as they basically starting to camp on people, and Hobby hits one into the net there. Don's in trouble at this point, looking for a solution for this rotation.
Right now their play selection's not fooling anybody. They're getting two blockers up every time.
Gislin goes for the mini floor wipe, which gives you the mini timeout.
Let's see if Chris dumps one on this play.
That ball's in, nice pass. We've got a pipe hit, and that ball's hit in. That's
great
a nice
shot.
Play.
Great shot by Ricky, back in the corner. Most teams don't put anybody on defense in the corner.
And Justin to serve, he's got a nice one cross court. They handle it, however, they go to middle. That ball is lifted. Poor Ryan just can't seem to penetrate on his middle blocking right now. It's just draining right in front of him.
He's dropping his hands down low. He's got to keep them up high.
Here we go again. Nice pass outside to Ricky. They got that double block. It's not dug up. Nice shot by Soler.
Chris is out there picking on the setter when he's in the front row, which is a great choice if you're IPFW.
And Ryan back to serve. He's got another one in here. And it's a pretty good pass. Back row hit by Zorn. It's blocked. It's out of bounds. So it's a side out.
Zorn really gets up. It would have been a good matchup to see him against Hector. But with Hector out with the flu.
And here we go. Justin handles that one. It's a 31 set. And it's drained right in front of their blocker. Didn't penetrate. So that'll be a side out. Gislin to serve. We'll use another ace here if we can get one. He smokes it. It definitely takes him out of their offense. They give us a free ball. And Ryan with an on-target pass. It's outside to Ricky. He smokes it down the line. Out of bounds. That ball goes. Point down.
Great job. Coach Ball in his pregame meeting was saying that the weak blockers for the Lakers are on the right side, so our left side hitters have to take advantage of that.
Score is 8-6 at this point, and we will be back after these messages.
Talk about unusual. How often do you see transparent televisions?
Americans have more money to spend on leisure activities than ever before.
When possible, children should trick-or-treat during daylight hours and be accompanied by at least one adult.
A boat, archaeologists believe, is from the time Jesus and his disciples fished on the Galilee.
For best results, fertilize your lawn when it is actively growing.
Many people suffer from allergies. Few understand them.
And we're back here. We're in the timeout. It's 8-6, almost out of this timeout that Mercyhurst called. Mercyhurst up 8-6 at this point. They've played pretty well so far this game.
The Dons are going to have to earn all their points. Starts with a good serve here by Chris Gislin. Take them out of their offense one more time. Let's see if we can get one point closer.
And here we go, Gislin with his jumper back to the cross court action. That ball's set too low, and he calls that ball down. I don't think that ball's down. How he can call
part it? Part of the ball hit the ground. Part of the ball hit the ground and out of bounds.
You called the ball down, you're totally out of bounds.
It doesn't matter.
And here we go with the card. Card on number 5 for arguing. 15, just arguing.
Captain Adam Tokas.
Needlessly. Here we go again. Gislin to serve. It's 7-8. Dons are behind. They get the nice serve again. Ball's outside. It's tipped this time. It's played up, and Ricky will be as a back row attack. He's over the line. They're giving it to him right now.
He's the front row player up there with Gislin serving.
I believe he is front row, or he looks like he's front row at this point. Yeah, he's front row, so he's legal on that play.
Found a hole in the block and put it down.
Gislin smokes another one here. Gash takes one off the block. They call it off the block. It was definitely off the block. Out of bounds. Justin, a little smile on his face as he knows what happened there. But the Nons are tied this one up here, 8-8. Not a well passed ball there, but Javi makes the most of it through the blocking down.
Andrew Mahaven out there, 6'3", and he's one of the weak blockers up there. Javi taking advantage of that.
Ricky to serve at this point. He puts one down the line to Zorn. They're really working Zorn over when he's front row, I notice. Zorn hits it out of bounds, trying to give him more than he can handle at this point. 9-8.
No, asking for a touch on that one. He sailed that one a long way out of bounds.
Goes for it again. Down the line. Nice pass. It's crossed by Zorn. He misses that. Sends it out of bounds.
Ryan Brock tried to dig it.
We got
a little bit slow.
Substitution. Number 17.
Andy Kuchbach
into the game for Zorn.
Just giving him a little time to settle down. Get a little frustrated. Got to get his composure back.
And he doesn't handle the ball well. They put it down the line as Ryan can't handle the tip very well.
Not a good job by Ryan. He got behind the block, didn't see what was happening.
Another substitution.
Todd Ledoux come in to serve for the Lakers.
Nice serve. That ball's passed well. It's outside to Justin. He's way off the net. It's played up by Cummings. Here we go. A nice set. Beautiful set to Javier Escobar, and he pounds it down.
Great job of Mike Cummings playing that ball up so that we can run our offense off the pass.
Well, we'll see how the Lakers do without their main man, Zorn, in the game here. They're working over the new sub with the passing already. And there's a nice block. It's played up, and they're in a scramble. It's over the net with a roll. Gislin with a nice back set to Javi. He works it. He's underneath the net. That'll be a side out for the Lakers.
Chris got a little too carried away, trying to get that ball a little too tight.
Don's had it all set up. Just a little too tight on the set as Javi makes this pass. Go right back to Javi. He rolls it. It's blocked but played up again. Another same thing happens. We got another opportunity. Third hitter will be Luna. Through the blocking down.
Giving their middle a lot of running back. He went, had to cover both sides of the net that time. He got a little bit slow getting out there to that last one.
Fans seem to be taking an interest in Luna's play at this point. And that ball is off the block. Great dig by Cummings. It's played over. And again, Ryan Perrott just cannot get his hands over the net. Off the hands, out of bounds.
Greg Beato for the Lakers. His setting style is really frustrating the IPFW middles.
Javi out of the D position, and he brushes that ball down. No play for the Lakers. Johns are ahead 10-8 at this point. Made a nice rally. Let's see what they do with it. Luna smokes one. It's set outside. Oh, huge roof.
Gislin with a great job of turning that ball back into the court.
11-8, that's the kind of thing that can spark you. Luna again with a big jumper. They go back to Tokash this time. He likes that right side, I've noticed. He really hits off the block well over there.
Our block's really trying to reach high instead of reaching over, getting in front of him.
Tamburino back in, the middle hitter.
Omar Hotzik to serve for the Lakers.
He puts one deep, and it's Obi. Ricky gives him the old fake pass.
And here comes the serving sub, Brian Harris.
Again, we're at that sticky point. We have a little bit of a lead, but it's kind of a back and forth thing. Let's see if Harris can break that that spell and give us some mo. He does. He gives us a great serve. Toe cash off the block. Great dig by Javi. He's going to get the ball. Rips it out of bounds.
Javi makes a great dig. He's got to finish the play, though.
And the serve moves to the Lakers. Number 7, Greg Vietto.
And we're back in the action here. Great pass by Luna. And it's blocked. A nice set, but Mike Cummings just not being able to get that ball through the block right now. They're penetrating well.
It's going right at the blocker instead of around him.
Ricky with a nice pass. They go outside to Ricky. He smokes it over the block and down. Side out dimes.
Ricky's stepping up for Hector's absence from the lineup right here. He's really hitting the ball high and over the block.
Chris doesn't like that toss. He'll retoss. Here we go. He smokes another one. Nice pass. And what do you know? A middle attack. Our block just doesn't seem to line up very well on their middle hitters.
No, it looked like he was watching the ball instead of watching his hitter.
Same
hitter just
again.
Went up around him.
Kind of watching, playing the setter instead of playing the hitter. Javi with a nice shot. That ball's in play. It's down. They're complaining.
They didn't like that first pass.
It was legal by today's standards. Ricky with his jump floater. It's handled well. It's a back set. They hit that ball in.
Matt Tamburino back to serve for the Lakers.
A short serve, handled well by Ricky. Javi on the weak side, off the block and out of bounds. We're going for a double sub at this point. As Jorge Relat is into the game for Cummings to serve. Play back for defense, and Ryan Perotta into the game in the middle front again. Normal sub.
Normally, Justin Luna would be coming in to serve. Jorge's
with a jumper, it's out of bounds. It's a point for the Dons. Great play by Jorge. He was awful close to that line when he took off.
He was awful close. I wouldn't want to be that line judge.
He goes again. He's back further this time, and so is the ball. It's out of bounds.
Good job of Jorge coming in, getting a point, getting us off at 11.
And we're back in. Ricky with a poor pass. Jorge with a set outside and a nice shot. They play it up well, though. One-on-one outside. Big block. It's just out of bounds. Just out of bounds. Nice block by Hobbs. Didn't penetrate enough, though. Timeout for the Dons. In fact, they're going to try to break their momentum as they hold an edge 12-10 at this point. IPFW head men's volleyball coach Arnie Ball, along with assistant coach Mark Kroenke, review recent activities and highlights each Thursday evening at 10:30 p.m. on Channel 6. Tune in to keep up with the team, meet the players, and find out what's ahead for the team. That's Thursday at 10:30 p.m. right here on College Access Channel 6.
Dons have to get the momentum back right here. Gotta slow this Mercyhurst team down.
Dons enter the court here out of this timeout. They'll need a side out here. They have three attackers at this point, I believe.
Yes, I think
Hobbs on the right side. Their next rotation is the tough one. Hobbs handles it. Goes outside to Justin. He's got a double block. It's played up. Oh, you can't call a lift on that. Why he called a lift on that, I'll never know. It just went through his hands. They don't call that anymore.
There you go.
But they did there. It's 12-11. That ball is out of bounds.
Big break for the Dons. They're struggling, and the Lakers give it right to them. They're in a bad rotation, and they hand it right to us.
Dons need to score here. We've got a floater. It's in. They go to the middle. It sneaks through Ryan Perrott.
Let's go, let's go.
How that happens, how they can sneak a ball through to the middle of the court around the middle blocker is beyond me. just not lining up very well with her middle attacker.
I'll have to keep an eye on Ryan to see if he's dropping his hands down when he blocks. He's got to keep them up.
Lakers serve it in. It's a tough pass. It's a pineapple. It's a great play. Ball's down.
Marino back there admiring how good his serve was.
Yeah, he thought that serve was pretty good.
Took him out of our offense.
Justin with his jumper. He's got one going. It's in. Nice pass, however. They go to the middle. Shocker. They go to the middle. Side out.
And we got caught flat-footed again. We got to be ready for that.
Here we go. It's in play again. Not necessarily a hard serve. It's in one-on-one. Ricky is up and over. It's dug up, however. That ball is back row, and it's blocked. It's played. It's hit. It's out. No, it's played. Javi out of the back row. It's dug out of bounds. Great hit by Javier Escobar.
We didn't give up on that play.
Cummings back into play.
We had the opportunity to settle down and start celebrating. We waited until the ball was clearly down before we started celebrating.
Ryan to serve. He's got one in. It's handled. Outside, double block, beautiful block. It's played, it's in play. It's gonna be a roll shot, semi-free ball on target. Outside to Ricky, shoots down the line, he scores. Point Dons.
Great job of execution by the Dons right there. Pass on target. Good set to the outside and put it away.
13-11, the Dons extend their lead. There's the 31 attack, it's played up. Poor play by Cummings, it results in a free ball. Marginal set, outside off the block. Side out for the Lakers. Mike Cummings doesn't flail at that ball, keeps his head. We get a pretty good play out of that, make it a good swing. Short serve, just a nice pass outside to Ricky. Radical angle handled by the Lakers. Tokash rips it, he scores.
Tokash really got a good arm swing. He hits that ball really well, really smart. Knows how to tool the block and hit around it.
They're in again, Ricky, nice pass. It's back to Hobbs, down the line, scoring. Is Javier Escobar side out 13-12 at this point. Chris Gislin back to serve. We all know what that can mean. He's got to have a ton of aces this match so far. To collect one there. In fact, that's his first service error of the match.
Got the Lakers' best hitter back serving, though. That may be a bonus for the Dons.
And the Dons have three hitters up. And Cummings is not sure what to do with it, so he'll play it out of bounds. Mike Cummings just got to get his head into this match here if the Dons are going to do something. Arnie Ball calling a timeout at 13-13. We'll be back after these messages.
Since you graduated from college, we haven't seen too much of you.
We know you've been very busy climbing the ladder of success.
We've been watching you on your way up,
and we've enjoyed seeing you put your degree to work.
Now, how about sharing your time with us?
Your expertise would come in handy, too.
You can reconnect with your alma mater through your alumni association.
It's time for you to come back to your campus.
Call your alumni office today.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodon. It's 13-13. Out of this timeout, the Dons have just called their second timeout. Dons are scrambling here at this point, not putting together the nondescript play so far in this game.
Yeah, when the other players are called to step in and set, they got to make that play. Mike Cummings has not been able to do that.
Tokash, beautiful serve, and Ricky smokes the hit with basically no blocker.
Right, the left side blocker committed on the middle, left Ricky wide open.
And Ricky serves his jump floater. It's in, handled by Tokash. Off the block, can't be recovered. Side out for the Lakers. We're stuck at 13 still. Who's going to break first is the question. Their serve is in. Ricky handles it. And Ricky has to make a shot out of it. Lucky play if they don't touch that ball. If the block doesn't touch it, it's an easy dig. They do touch it. It goes out of bounds. Side out for Dons.
Back row defense was all lined up for it. Changed the direct trajectory of it.
Mike Cummings has a nice serve deep. Takes them out of their offense. Double blocks up. Off the block. Out of bounds. They got to turn your hands in on that play. It's a tight set and it's inside. You know what's going to happen. We should be roofing that ball.
Javier starts looking at the ball instead of the hitter.
Oh, another one down the line. Just take advantage of their outside blocking at this point.
Javier really twisted that ball back. Here's his floater.
Ball was out of bounds.
Javier got a little distracted over there on the pass. Probably should have dropped it and tossed it again.
Serves in. And there's a big block. It's out of bounds. 14 to 13. They score. Gaining a game point opportunity here. They serve. It's in. Nice pass. Ricky out of the back row. He hits it. That ball's in. Lakers are calling for out, but they all knew it was in.
He's having a little fun with the line judge back there.
Trying to influence and win friends. They don't. Great serve. It's played up. Tokash on the weak side. It's played up. It's a free ball in essence. And here we go. Outside to Tokash. Great dig by Luna! And Cummings gives him the free ball. Another free ball, weak side hit coming up. No, two ball, tipped. Oh my gosh, we're in the net on a weak attempt. What can we be thinking about?
Here we go for game point. Great job by Tokash, mixing his shots up, mixing his sets up.
Ball's in, nice pass by Ricky. It's outside to Ricky, he shoots. It's blocked, it's down, point game for the Lakers. Score is 1-1 now in games. Poor effort by IPFW in that game.
Bad choice of sets to end the game. Everybody knew where that set was going. They had two blockers lined up for it.
And we will be right back after these messages.
Check it out.
The campus has it all.
Learn it, or work it, or play it, just do it. It's a cool place. Call now. Go to work, go to school, go ahead.
Your parents are always bugging you to get out of the house and get some exercise. But you've got your own way of doing things. You're your own person. You don't need to follow the crowd or the rules. And the last people you want to be like are your parents.
Johnny, tell them what they want.
Michael Jordan, UNCF, take one.
We're here to tell you about the College Fund. It was set up to help deserving kids get a chance to be what they want to be. Are there any future doctors in the house?
Yeah!
Any scientists?
Yeah!
What about teachers?
Yeah!
All right, now who's going to play professional basketball? Come on. It's a good job. Please join me and support the College Fund. Your mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Yeah!
The IPFW Omnibus Lecture Series proudly welcomes Speaker Douglas Wilder, former presidential candidate and first black governor in U.S. history, Thursday, February 19th at 7:30 p.m. in the Wall Ballroom, sponsored by News Channel 15.
100% unadulterated energy. You have no choice but movement. You aren't acted on. You are action. You have the power to make the world a better place. You already know how to do it. Volunteer now for the American Red Cross. Call your local chapter for details.
I haven't made up my mind yet. What are you gonna take?
Algebra.
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 If no one's explained how algebra, geometry, and calculus can improve your future, demand that you be told. Call NACME. We'll tell you.
Talk about unusual. How often do you see transparent televisions?
Americans have more money to spend on leisure activities than ever before.
When possible, children should trick or treat during daylight hours and be accompanied by at least one adult.
A boat, archaeologists believe, is from the time Jesus and his disciples fished on the Galilee.
For best results, fertilize your lawn when it is actively growing.
Many people suffer from allergies. Few understand them.
Hi, I'm Edward James Olmos. On the streets of Fort Wayne, there's a battle going on. It's about kids fighting kids and families fighting families. Our youth are struggling to survive. Without positive alternatives to gangs, drugs, and violence, many will end up incarcerated or dead. You can make a difference by supporting the Multicultural Youth Advisory on Gangs and its programs. They provide alternatives for youth. Together we can stop the violence and increase the peace. To learn how you can make a difference in the lives of youth, please call.
This is the National Radon Test. Answer true or false. Radon is a form of radiation that builds up in homes. The Office of the Surgeon General recommends all homes be tested for radon. Radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. Testing your home is easy, and radon problems can be fixed. You're going to protect your family from radon by calling 1-800-SOS-RADON.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome here. We are in between games. It's game three coming up, 1-1. Stats, Colin, how are we looking?
Well, Mercyhurst definitely turned it around in that game. They out-hit us, they out-dug us, and they definitely out-blocked us in that game. We had more service errors, and we just got outplayed all around that game.
Our overall skill percentage has dropped to 277, while Mercyhurst is at 354. We start the third game. Gislinda serve. It touches the net. Side out to the Lakers.
Not a good sign. Not a good way to start a game.
And here we go. Off. Off the block, but kept in play. Free ball. Tons go again. And Holly off the block, out of bounds.
We're going to keep this, swinging.
This evening's IPFW men's volleyball match on Channel 6 is brought to you by Fujifilm USA, the Chestnut Group, and Farm Bureau Insurance as Ricky serves it in the net. Not another good start. 0-2 on serving. Are the Dons?
Can't score many points if you can't serve the ball in the court.
It's rather tough to score there. Green set, it's a kill. Hottie trying to pick his teammates up.
I've noticed that with Hector out of the lineup, we're much more effective from the right side than from the left side.
And there's a nice serve, but they're in system. They run the middle. Gislin with a dig, it's saved, it's played up. Oh, it's still good. And Ricky swings, and it's a nice dig. Back to the middle again. And that ball's going to be swung on hit. It's out of bounds, but Justin Luna's in the net. That'll be a side out for the Lakers.
Lakers keeping that ball in play, making IPFW make the mistakes.
Short serve handled well by Ryan. Javi, one blocker, that's a kill. We'll be doing that. I think that combination of the 31 with the back green is a good one for the Dons. Getting Javi into the offense with one blocker is going to be a kill every time.
Our serving is looking pathetic again.
We're what, 1-for-4 in this game on serving, I think.
And the Lakers, number 17, Anthony
Kuzma. Zorn still sits out for the Lakers. They take out their stud and win the game. That says something for motivation, I think, as that ball's hit out of bounds. Point Lakers.
When you can win with your star player on the bench,
that sometimes motivates some people, too. You see Zorn come back in, he might really be ready to play.
He might have something to prove when he comes back in. Ricky's really picking it up. Big shot out of the back row for the Dons there.
Here we go, Justin with his spinner, it's in. Marginal pass, they have no offense out of the deal. We get a good pass, and Ricky swings, it's dug. It's set outside, a roll shot, it's play, Justin, nice play. Ricky again, down the line, off the block, kill.
Right now, the middle blocker for the Lakers is paying no attention to our middle. We gotta get those guys involved.
We got to get them off the net. They're just too tight to the net. Sets are too tight. They're just having no power, no effect. They're easy to block when they're tight. And that's just you know, a mental thing our middles have to, mental adjustment the middles have to make.
And that's another point as Tokash hits one out of bounds.
But we serve another one out of bounds. I think we're trying to do some kind of a serving error record this game. Here we go, it's back to Javi with no block this time out of the deep position. It's a free ball, played well by the Dons. And again, Javi, yeah, I think he ought to see a few more of those.
That's a great set. We're really hitting well, either the D sets, the green sets, anything on the back side, we are really pounding the ball.
They're just trying to load up on our front side, leaving our back side alone. Great serve takes him out. They run the middle. It's played up by Javi, and Javi gets it. He tips it. It's dug. It's a swing. But a nice dig by Javi again. Ricky outside, double block. He goes for everything, but the Lakers are in the net. So the Dons will get a point.
Number 7, Greg Beato into the net. Ties the score at 2.
Ryan with another serve, it's a nice one. Takes them out of their offense, backcourt hit. Block is good and down for the kill. The score is 4-2.
Scoreboard operates a little slow.
Maybe it's 4-1. I think it's 4-1, it's 4-1. And here we go again, another marginal pass, gives us a double block. Ricky with a nice pass, back to Ricky. He goes down the line, kill. Caranciola, 5-1.
Great job, Ricky, of making that pass high enough so they could get back outside, make an approach.
And Mercyhurst takes a timeout, so we will continue after these messages.
Hi, I'm Edward James Olmos. On the streets of Fort Wayne, there's a battle going on. It's about kids fighting kids and families fighting families. Our youth are struggling to survive. Without positive alternatives to gangs, drugs, and violence, many will end up incarcerated or dead. You can make a difference by supporting the Multicultural Youth Advisory on Gangs and its programs. They provide alternatives for youth. Together we can stop the violence and increase the peace. To learn how you can make a difference in the lives of youth, please call.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome. Coming out of this timeout, the Dons are up 5-1 as the Lakers take their first timeout. Ryan Perrott back to serve.
Dons got off to a really shaky start with their poor serving, but all of a sudden they've picked it up.
Now you can't call that. You can't call that a lift, and the Dons have a cow, and they as well as they should. That is not supposed to be a lift. It's a great dig. Arnie has something to say about that. Ricky gets the ball. He has to roll it on a poor set. It's tipped sort of over, but this will be the third contact. It should be four. They don't call four. Why, I don't know. I saw it hit four people.
I think Mike Cummings blocked the ball back on them, so they had another three hits coming.
Here we go again. Lakers are back into this one all of a sudden. Poor passing by the Dons as Ricky goes off the block out of bounds. For the kill, Gislin back to serve.
Tokaš almost ran that ball down again. He's a hustler out there for the Lakers.
And it's a nice cross-court serve. Tokaš off the right side, it's dug by Javi. Beautiful dig, it's back to Javi. He gets a shot. Luna with the coverage, and it's a spinner and a half-hearted whistle by our official. On a throw, I guess.
Hey, Javi didn't get out of Chris's way that time. He's got to let him set it.
Ball is deep. I thought it was out, but Javi will get the ball nonetheless off the block, out of bounds, to the commentators.
Five. The Lakers trying to claim there was no touch on the block, but that ball took a right angle turn.
5-2, our score, we're still in play here. It's outside, it's a bad play by the Dons. They're in the net on a terrible set by the Lakers. They had nowhere to go. Why force the issue? Why get into the net? Unnecessary.
Gotta watch the hitter, he was gonna take the ball. We could have played that easy.
There we go, passes over the net and played down. Nice play by the Dons. That's what you get out of a tall setter. Lakers are asking for an over, but they won't get it, as that certainly was still partly on our side.
Another fundamental mistake by the Laker middle.
There's a nice serve by Mike Cummings for an ace. He got one going there.
Ball had some definite movement on there. Andy Kutzbach.
Scores 6-2.
Hang with it.
He serves another tough one. It's in. Out back to him, big block, that'll cost them. I don't think they can ride a whole lot on that outside hitter. Setter has to know that, you know, after he passes a tough one, you can't set him, you gotta set the ball somewhere else. I bet somebody else gets this ball, unless we serve it in the net.
I guess two's our limit. We can't serve more than 2 points without putting one out of bounds or in the net.
Gotta make sure they get their opportunities. And so we overpass it. It's played down. Easy kill.
Chris Gislin tried to fake block, but being a back row setter, he can't go up and block on that.
Here we go again. Justin Luna with a pass. It's a little better. It's over, however. Back row attack on Chris Gislin, a back row setter.
All of a sudden, the Lakers are coming back into this. Two bad points, bad passes.
7-4, our score. There's a good pass. We can run something on that. Ricky, big old hit. Now, why can he call that ball down? I'll never know. That ball is not down. That ball is in play.
We got to get the whole ball up there. He's got to get the whole ball up.
Maybe he's still got that quick whistle from the old rules.
I don't know what he's calling there. He can't call that ball down because it never hit the floor. It went off his leg. It's fairly obvious. It was like 3 foot off the floor, so I don't know what he's calling there.
Whatever it was, took some air out of the ball. They had to put a new ball into play.
So Javi whips it into the play. A tight set. It's played up. Ricky with the set to Gislin. That surprises everybody, as they weren't expecting that. Usually your non-setter will not try to back set a ball, but Ricky with extensive setting experience and Gislin, a fair hitter himself, they provide a surprise attack on the Lakers. Nice dig by IPFW, and Ricky with a play. They call it a down again, and I think that one might be hit on the floor, but it certainly looked like a good dig.
That one was definitely down. The one before should have been kept in play.
Okay, you too can participate in the excitement of IPFW Athletics by joining the Royal Dons Club. The Royal Dons Club is the official booster club for IPFW's athletic teams. Members enjoy priority seating at all IPFW sports events, food and refreshments in the hospitality room, admission to IPFW sports media luncheons, and association with other Mastodon supporters. For information on becoming a member of the Royal Dons Club, call Pat Klein at 481-6643 or write to Royal Dons Club, 2101 East Coliseum Boulevard, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46805.
Great job of the Dons. Giving up 2 points, coming back and scoring two of their own.
So the Dons take a 9-4 lead at this point. Mercyhurst a little bit on their heels after the call by Dave Sines up top. Dons need to take advantage of that. As Javi puts it into play, he goes deep, it's in. Middle this time, Ryan smokes it out on the hitter correctly, penetrates the net, and guess what happens, Colin?
Hey, we finally block a ball in the middle.
10-4. Ball's in again. Tokash, bad pass, free ball. Ryan, good pass. Oh, what a set. That ball is in. And that's a great set by a sprawling Gisslin. Here we go again. Hobby with another nice play. It goes outside. It's blocked but played up. We'll see what kind of hit they get out of this. They don't get any hit. It's a free ball. Hobby on target. Justin with a nice shot, cross court, kill, point, 12-4 Dons.
The Lakers are stuck in this bad rotation right here.
George Ikovu entering the game for Mike Cummings. Let's see what George looks like. He's been fighting a serious flu bug for about 2 weeks now. Not been able to practice much. Chris Farmer in same shape. Those are our two backup middles.
Jim Zorn back in for the Lakers. This is the rotation where they're passing to the left side instead of the right side of the court. Their hitters are both to the right side. So Jim Zorn gonna come in off the bench. He's gotta be loose and ready to get this ball.
And he gets the first one as he should. Ricky with a strange dig. It gets out to Justin somehow. He takes a swing at it. They go outside, Zorn, but guess who's in the net? The Dons. Side out. 12-4.
We're making the back row plays right now. It's getting let down at the net.
Dons have carried the momentum thus far. Nice pass. Back to Javi. They're getting a better block up, but it's nowhere near enough to contain Mr. Escobar.
They cannot stop anything on the right side. Chris Gislin's realizing that, and he's really running it.
Oh, what a heck of a play by Justin Luna. Great shot down the line as Tokash has had some passing problems here lately.
Put some heat on that one. Let's see if he can keep this one in.
He goes to him again. And it's back out to Tokash. He's got to roll it. Here goes Justin with a nice pass in. Back to Javi. They get a nice play on it. It's tight. It's out of bounds, off the block. Point done.
Great job by Chris Gislin, realizing that pass was tight. Two blockers up, he goes up and tools the blocker.
They're asking for a timeout, but I think they've used all their timeouts. They don't award any. Justin on the line. It's, oh man.
Zorn from the back row. He's had a nice rest. He ought to be fired up.
Let's see what kind of game he starts to put forward. Maybe not in this game, but the next game, I bet he might be fired up. We got another sub for the Lakers.
Got
to do in.
Zorn's their top player, and maybe he can get fired up, get loosened up for the next game, because I don't think they have a chance of winning this one.
That ball's in. Justin with a nice pass. On target to Javi. Smoking.
He was flying on that one.
He is just airborne tonight.
He took off from well behind the 10-foot line. It almost landed at the net.
You can just tell when somebody gets in a rhythm like Javi, you're just not going to stop him, and he's just is zoning right now as Brian Harris comes in to serve this one out. Goes outside. Oh, it's a big hit cross court. 14-4 is our score.
George didn't reach in, didn't take the angle that time. He's got to watch the hitter a little more closely.
Well, let's see if George might get set right about here. He does. It's dug. And it's tipped out of bounds, off the antenna, side out guns. Gislin back to serve.
And everybody's on their feet. See if we can end it with an ace here.
That would be good. It's a nice shot. It takes them out of their offense. They get some kind of a waffle hit out of the deal. Great set. Oh, my goodness. Javier Escobar, no block. It's a crusher.
Javier, one on none, straight down. What a great way to end a game.
That's taking it with authority, and we will continue after these messages.
Since you graduated from college, we haven't seen too much of you.
We know you've been very busy climbing the ladder of success.
We've been watching you on your way up,
and we've enjoyed seeing you put your degree to work.
Now, how about sharing your time with us?
Your expertise would come in handy, too.
You can reconnect with your alma mater through your alumni association.
It's time for you to come back to your campus.
Call your alumni office today.
Hi, Puddin.
Oh, you're so cute. I don't have shoes.
Oh, if you are gorgeous. Noreen. Talk to me. Come on, you can do it.
Get the keys. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
The IPFW Omnibus Lecture Series proudly welcomes speaker Douglas Wilder, former presidential candidate and first black governor in U.S. history, Thursday, February 19th at 7:30 p.m. in the Wall Ballroom, sponsored by News Channel 15.
What if you had to choose between a flower and an elephant? What would you choose? What if you had to decide between a 100-year-old tree and a 1,000,000-year-old beach? Could you choose between drinking clean water or breathing clean air? Now you can choose all these things. EarthShare, the world's leading environmental groups working together. It's one choice we can all live with.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome. We're in between games 3 and 4. The Dons have just taken a lead 2-1 on an awesome kill by Mr. Escobar. Colin, what do you see in the stats?
Well, IPFW really dominated that third game, not only on the scoreboard, but in the stats. Previous game, Mercyhurst hit 354, and this game they only hit 77.
Here's our replay of the last point. Serving by Gislin, he gives us a great shot as they don't get any kind of attack, and here you can see Javi coming around.
Two blockers went up on George. Great job of George just driving, making some noise, holding the blockers.
Oh, you gotta like that. Well, this evening's IPFW Men's Volleyball match on Channel 6 is brought to you in part by Fujifilm USA, by the Chestnut Group Incorporated, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Dons really built some momentum in that third game. Let's see if they can carry it on here and close out the match with a quick fourth game.
Certainly did. Nice job by the Dons as we've got Javier Escobar hitting about 500 and Ricky Soler also hitting at 477. Both with magnificent kill ratio here. 24 kills for the Hobbs and 26 kills for Ricky. Nobody else even close to that. Justin Loon is next in line with 7 kills.
That's because both those players hit on the right side. And Chris Gislin, the setter's been using that set a lot as it's proved most effective for the Dons.
Once again, the Dons are leading in digs to kill ratio. 22 for the Dons, only 5 for the Lakers. You would think that that would be maybe reversed a little bit, as the Lakers are supposed to be the defensive team, but we're off again, and Ricky passes the ball on target. He swings, hits down for the kill.
Still not a whole lot of holding the middle.
And Gislin's ready to serve. He fires one long this time. It's out of bounds.
Chris has been pretty consistent with that. That's only his second serving error of the game.
He's done well. That one's in. Next play, no block really to speak of. That's a kill for the Dons. I think that X has just pretty much worked all night long.
Certainly much so.
As well as the weak side. I think as long as we use that combination hitter on either side of the setter, we're going to score. Zorn with a big hit. Gislin with a set out of the pipe. And Ricky with a kill.
Nice take by Ryan Perrott there, so they're able to run their offense. That's how everything's got to start.
Ricky's going for his jump floater. It's out of bounds. Tough break.
Got to be a little closer than that, though.
Lakers put it into play. Here comes Gissel with the middle, and it's too low to George. George hits it into the net.
He had the opening. He just tried to hit it too straight down.
Yeah, he just wasn't set high enough to go for that angle. They go to him again. It's far behind him, as George is one of those tight hitters. He likes to go right next to the net. Tips it down for the kill.
Great job by George. Seeing the hole and putting it in to the side out.
And that ball's in. Zorn handles it. They go back to Zorn. He hits it down the line. Easy kill.
IPFW blockers have to communicate a little more. Zorn passed on the left side and hit on the right side.
We're back in action here. And Ricky out of the D. It's Doug. They go for their D hit. Not much of one. However, it's dug up. Ricky sets it outside. Justin off the block. Great shot. Oh, and they don't see it. Oh, my gosh. How do you miss that? Holy smokes.
Not supposed to miss those calls when you're at home.
Good heavens. That was, that one just ricocheted like 10 feet off the blocker's hands as we get a miscommunication here.
Point to the Lakers. Makes it 3-1.
Bad job of the Dons of losing their composure when they didn't get the call.
So the score benefits the Lakers, 3-1. Outside to Luna, they get a block, it's 4-1 all of a sudden, just like that. The Lakers get the momentum and the major lead. I don't think the Dons want to go 5 here tonight. Here we go, it's the D hitter, and that's Doug. It's out of play, however. We just got to continue to use that right side offense, I think.
Yep. Dons are unstoppable from that side. Javier and Ricky just got to keep feeding them the ball.
And here we go with the jumper that's in. And somebody who's not ready, that ball's playable. It's good. Oh, and Justin quits it. The ball is in play. And the Dons just totally give up on it.
This one's out of bounds, this play.
Here we go again, as Ricky comes out of the pipe position, drains it off the middle blocker. Dons have really gone into a mental lapse here, I think. Really not focusing well at this point. They need to pull it together.
They're trying to cruise a little bit. They got to take it to them.
That ball's out of bounds. Like I say, they're just cruising right now, hoping the Lakers kind of give them this fourth game so they really don't have to work for it. The Lakers aren't complying, however. Ball goes outside to Ricky on a one-on-one. That ball hits the antenna on its way over, so that's a point for the Lakers. They're up 5-1 at this point. Might be looking for a timeout from Coach Ball. Serve is in. Pass is on target. Ricky hits one cross court. Nice shot, nice kill.
Ricky's being affected from both sides, but we got to get Justin Luna involved in the offense as well as our middles.
So Ryan goes back to serve. He's got a nice one there. Outside, kill off the hands of Gislin.
Chris is a little slow getting out there. A quick set like that, you got to beat the hitter out there, and he didn't make it.
Ball's in play, nice serve, good pass. George with a kill out of the middle. We haven't seen the kill out of the middle since, I don't know, what, a decade or so?
Yeah, George had a dink, but not a hard shot.
We got a hard shot there, and Gislin to jumper. It's hitting the net. He's kind of falling apart with his service. Folks just can't seem to pull it together mentally at this point. Lakers go up, and they snap off a nice one. Gislin gets a good set. Off-balance shot. There's a net by Zorn, and he knows it's a major error. Major, major error.
Ricky had no shot that time, so he was going for the fingers, and he missed them totally. Dons are fortunate.
Ricky to serve, he gets one in. Tokash with a pass, it's back. Oh, that ball's off the block. Unfortunately, Javier Escobar is not known for his defense as he was on his heels, not ready to go forward. But Javi is in position to receive some kind of a back set, which we don't get. We come out of the pipe, and it's a kill. I'd say it's a two-man show right now with Ricky and Hobbs trading punches.
As long as we keep passing the ball on target, we can keep feeding them. Got to have consistent passing.
George with a nice serve down the line. Good pass. It's a tip. And it's played up, sort of, somewhat. And we got people running into each other, falling all over the place. Side out for the Lakers. No communication on the Don side.
Gotta take advantage of those free balls when they give it to us.
And we're off and running. We're certainly passing the ball well. As Javi has a miss hit on a one-on-one, sails it out of bounds.
That's 6-1 now.
The offense is there. We're just not making it happen. There's another one. It's stuffed by Zorn on a one-on-one.
That one was a little tight. Zorn's a big blocker out there. Got to keep Javi back off the net so he can hit around him.
7-1. They take a big lead at this point. Ricky out of the back row. It's a kill. Why they just don't put three blockers on Ricky, I'm not sure.
Their outside blockers fail when they see it's not coming to their hitter.
And there we go again. It's a crossing play. That ball is called in on a serious angle. I don't know how he got snuck that one in there, but he did.
Two blockers up, and he went around them and pounded it down.
Lakers are feeling their oats right now. And we're off and running again as it's out to Justin. That ball is out of bounds. Just not very good setting right now.
They're missing Hector a little bit, maybe, but we got to hit the ball in court.
And that ball is in. Another marginal pass. That ball is out of bounds. 9-1. I think we're seeing a timeout from the Dons. So we will return with more action after these messages.
This is the National Radon Test. Enter true or false. Radon is a form of radiation that builds up in homes. The Office of the Surgeon General recommends all homes be tested for radon. Radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. Testing your home is easy, and radon problems can be fixed. You're going to protect your family from radon by calling 1-800-SOS-RADON.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodon. Dons are down 9-1 at this point. Game four, it's a struggle. If we can come back out of this one and win this game, that's gonna be saying something for the Dons, as they've totally fallen apart at this point.
Two totally different teams out here, that's for sure.
We're just making Mercyhurst feel pretty good about themselves, I think, here tonight.
That's right.
And we're back in play here. Good pass. Ricky out of the back row. That ball's down. Shocker. Ricky out of the pipe for a kill.
IPFW is getting very predictable right now on their offense. Let's see if they can play some defense now.
Luna serves one in. They go out of the pipe. Zorn, great dig! Awesome dig, and they hit it out of bounds, and Gislin doesn't turn it in. What a dig by Luna. He is just comes up with the most spectacular plays. Serve is in. The pass is good. Out to Ricky. Off the block and in. Off the block and in. Point for the Lakers.
Set was low and tight. Ricky couldn't get to it, and he got trapped. Couldn't tool the blocker.
You know, and the passes are right on the money here for the Dons, and we're just not getting quality swings at the ball. And there's Ricky Soler with one on nobody, and he sails it again.
Little frustration on the part of Ricky.
Just not very good without a block up there, is he?
Oh, that's twice he's had one on none. Couldn't find the court.
Dons are really struggling at this point to find any kind of rhythm. It's 11-1 in favor of Mercyhurst. And heck, and it's
Javier
into the net, not even close. Looks like the Dons have given up.
And the Lakers bench, they're calling for the serves. They're just telling them to keep the ball in play. They're not trying to make it tough. They're realizing that IPFW is struggling. They're just going to make them handle the ball as much as possible.
Ricky's calling for the ball right now. Give it to me. I bet we'll see him get it. Here we go. Ricky gets it. He's over the block and down. Two-man block was up. Didn't matter.
Finally, a side out. We were stuck in that rotation.
Well, there was a quality set. Points. You know, there's a quality set, and the rest weren't. And, you know, it's about that simple, I think. That ball served in, handcuffs them a bit, but they get a pass. They run a middle. It's out of bounds. Point for the Dons. They sorely needed point. 2-12 at this point. Time for a comeback. You got to be perfect, though, if you're going to make a comeback from here.
Got to keep that serve in right here.
That ball is going deep. It's in. It's played. Middle attack again. We don't get our hands over the net, so they score.
Chris Gislin was slow closing the block, but Mike Cummings was not lined up properly. He's lined up on him. That ball's an easy block.
They serve down the line. Another good pass. It's out to Ricky. He swings. It's off the block. It's played up. It's good. It's in. And there's a big hit. Another one coming up. It's blocked again, and there's a tip shot off the block, out of bounds. Great joust at the net.
Got to keep pounding that ball down. Eventually, it's going to find some floor over there.
Gislin to find a jumper at this point. We need something. He's got a good one. And there's a big old block. We penetrated on that one.
Mike Cummings did a great job of not committing to the middle block. The middle hitter, seeing that X play come around, he went up and snuffed it.
Gislin to serve again at 3-12. He whips one, it's out of bounds. Out of bounds.
Great momentum killer.
And they serve it, Ricky handles it with his hands. Easy kill for Ricky, there it is again, the weak side offense.
Jim Zorn. Blocker for Mercyhurst, trying to help in the middle. Didn't get outside to cover his hitter. Their middle blocker committed to our middle hitter. Got a one-on-one on the outside. We're wiping the floor, now we're ready to go.
Rookie's got to have a ball to serve, however, and there it comes. Ricky to serve his jump floater. No, it's a jump spinner. Handled well. It's outside his arm. He smokes it. Brock tries to dig it. Just couldn't handle it enough, though. Side out.
Lined up right. He's got to make that play.
And we've got a side out here as Ledoux comes in. Standard sub for the Lakers.
See, right now in this rotation, that Jim Zorn, number 10, is going to get all the sets for Mercyhurst.
It's in. Handled by Justin on target. Ricky out of the pipe. He hits that ball. It's in. They call that one in. Cummings back to serve. Let's see what he can do. He's got one going long. It's handled. They run it outside. It's a tight one.
And over the top of Javier.
Javi couldn't do anything with that as it went way over the top of him.
Might have been a little early on his block, but Jim Thorne's a leaper.
Nice pass. Here we go with the offense. It's Ricky out of the D. He hits that one. They're in the net. The ball's in anyway. It doesn't matter. And we've got a sub, and we're seeing Hector. Here comes Hector for Justin Luna.
First time tonight. See if he can get into play and make a difference right away.
That ball's in. It's handled. They back set it against Hector. The ball is hit in. That'll be a side out for the Lakers.
Ryan Perrott didn't set the block up right. He floated right past it. He's got to get out there, get stopped, and go straight up.
I got to think they're going to serve Hector. They try to. Ricky handles it, however. That ball goes to Ricky. He smokes it out of bounds. Not even close. Point for the Lakers. That will get 13-3. Causes a timeout to be called by IPFW. IPFW head men's volleyball coach Arnie Ball, along with assistant coach Mark Franke, review recent activities and highlights each Thursday evening at 10:30 p.m. on Channel 6. Tune in to keep up with the team, meet the players, and to find out what's ahead for the team. That's Thursday at 10:30 p.m. right here on College Access Channel 6. Well, Colin, where do we stand in this match?
Well, right now, all the momentum's with Mercyhurst. They're coming out, they're putting the ball down in court. IPFW's killing themselves with hitting errors. We've got to be hitting a negative percentage for this match because all the points we've given to them, they've earned a few, but not to have a 10-point lead this late in the match.
And so the teams take the floor again as Mercyhurst is ready to serve. Let's see if they try to get Hector. Zorn to serve. He fires it at Ricky. And there's a tight one, and Hector over the block, in. That ball touches the line. That was a tough hit to make as that set was way off the net. He had to almost jump backwards.
Chris Kislin is really struggling right now for the Dons.
Hector would normally go with a jump serve, but he's not warm at all, so he goes for a floater and hits the net anyway.
Matt Tamburino back in to block in the front row for Mercyhurst.
And here we go. That ball's handled by Ricky. And Ricky's getting the ball, and he's way over the block and down. Nice play by Ricky Soler. As long as Kislin can set him with that nice hanging platter set. It just floats up there, and it's served up on a platter like that. Ricky's going to score.
Great job of Mike Cummings to hold the middle blocker. He was late getting over there, and Ricky went right over top of him.
And after the Lakers substitution, Ryan Perrott to serve for the Dons. He's got it going down the line. Nice serve. Tokash tips it. Ricky plays it. Javi sets it up for Ryan. He tries to roll it. He rolls it way over the court, not a bounds.
Nice choice of a shot by Tokash. Dons played some defense, got the ball up. They just got to keep the ball in play.
You just got to take a rip at that ball and expect you're going to get set. And I don't think he expected he was going to get set, but there was no other hit, anybody else to hit the ball at that point.
In this offense, you got to be ready all the time. You never know when Chris is going to give you the ball.
And we're off and running. It's trying to serve short down the line. Back set to Hobbs. He's off the block, but it's Doug. Back row attack to Zorn. Perrott with a huge dig. Outside to Ricky. Swings off the block. Cummings makes it happen, though. Ricky again with a roll shot. It's snuck out there by their setter. Outside. Turned in by Gislin's hand. It's still in play. We'll get a free ball to the Dons. Can they handle the pass? They do. On target. Ricky gets it. Out of bounds, however. And you know you got a free ball You have a free ball, and they have a double block standing outside on Ricky. There's not any deception happening on the Don side of the net.
We have really gone away from running our middle at all. So right now, we've got to work on building some momentum for this fifth game.
And so, Justin Luna enters the game again as Ricky goes off the block out of bounds. And the Dons down 3-14. Looks like we're going five.
Got to build some momentum here with some good serves.
And there's another nice serve by Gislin as they go outside. Nice dig. Gislin handles it. Oh, it's in. It's going. It's a quick bing, bang, bong play. Combination. Another one. Out of bounds this time. The Dons keep swinging away at it.
Mercyhurst is showing you that defense that they're known for, keeping that ball alive.
Little pinball action on the Lakers' side of the net. As Gislin whips one up, that's a lift, but it's not called. And that's a worse play. Can the Dons get it that time?
And some more momentum building on the Dons' side here.
Timeout by the Lakers is that's 14-5, and there's a little mini momentum going for the Dons. So we will take a break and come back after these messages.
The power of you, the power of you. You are the hope that comes shining through.
Did you know you have the power to change the world around you for the better? It's the power of you and your local United Way to reach out and make a difference in all of our lives.
Never underestimate the power of you.
Welcome back to the IPFW Last to Go. It's Mercyhurst out front in the fourth game, 14-5, as the Dons have made a little mini jump here. We'll see if they can continue that, make that build a little bigger here. They need to make something happen for the fifth game at least.
They're starting to come alive, starting with some good serves by Chris Gislin here.
And then we're off. Fits into the net off the timeout is not a good sign for the Dons.
Chris has got to shake it off right here and make a good set.
Game point for the Lakers. It's another nice pass for the Dons. Ricky on the weak side. Kill. Straight down.
Jim Zorn trying to help in the middle too much. Couldn't get outside to stop Ricky.
And Ricky with another nice spin. A little more pinball action by the Lakers. Doesn't work this time. A serve. Point for the Dons. 6-14. Trying to cut that lead in half here if they can get another point right here. Another nice pass, however. Zorn tips the ball out of bounds. No touch, point. Dons at 7-14. They've cut the lead in half.
Great job of Justin Luna of not reaching out after that ball.
Here comes the Dons as Ricky goes up with his jump serve. It's set outside to Zorn. He goes up over and down the line. Hill. Sub for the Lakers. Their front row middle comes back in.
Omer Hatzik. Back in.
And they go with a short serve as Luna handles that well. Ricky out of the back row, and he just crushes the ball. That just cannot be handled.
I can't believe that Mercyhurst is going to let that go on over and over again.
I'd be setting that from now till the end of the match. It's certainly not being blocked. There's a nice block over the net by Javier Escobar. 8-14. I think we might see a timeout coming up here pretty quick by the Lakers.
Quite a comeback. It was 14-3 at one point.
At any point, we have some nice momentum for the next game if we'd serve the ball in. I think we might be able to make this comeback, but we continue to serve out after we create some momentum. And when you're down 14-1, it's really difficult to win the game then. Oh, they blocked that time, and there's the game point. There's the game point to move this to five games.
finally figured out the IPFW offense.
As the teams will make a coin toss at this time to see who serves and who receives. Let's see if we can't read the lips here of what's going to happen. And it looks like we can't tell what's going to happen. So we will go to a station break here, and we'll be back after these messages.
Team spirit is alive and well at IPFW. That's because IPFW has established itself as an athletic power, not only regionally, but nationally. With 11 major sports, IPFW offers talented student athletes great opportunities. Success and support of IPFW athletics comes solely from the fans, students, faculty, alumni, and the prestigious Royal Dons Club. The Royal Dons Athletic Club has over 500 members who financially support IPFW athletics, enabling the university to provide scholarships to deserving athletes. Members will receive one or all of the following: season passes to all sporting events, special seating, hospitality room, plus Royal Dons apparel and gifts. Be a part of the winning tradition. Join the Royal Dons Club. We need your support. Call IPFW Athletics. Get into the team spirit.
The IPFW Omnibus Lecture Series proudly welcomes speaker Douglas Wilder, former presidential candidate and first black governor in U.S. history, Thursday, February 19th at 7:30 p.m. in the Wall Ballroom, sponsored by News Channel 15.
It is a test, not just of strength, but of the power of the mind. And if you complete the journey, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Welcome back to the Gate Sports Center. This is Tim Harford, along with Colin Leiter, calling the action for you tonight. We have just ended game four, and it's 2-2 in games for a final fifth game. Rally score, no cap. The Dons will start serving on the same side they were just on. They will switch at 8 points. Looking at the stats real quickly, Javier really didn't add any totals to his kills, but Ricky Soler did. He went up to 43. Kills. However, the Dons only hit a measly 133.
After game three, which they won 15-4, they turn around. In that game, they hit 531. Then they get beat 15-8, and hit only 133. So
this evening's IPFW men's volleyball match on Channel 6 is brought to you in part by Fujifilm USA, the Chestnut Group Incorporated, and Farm Bureau Insurance.
Let's see. Usually Chris Gislin's our first server, so Coach Ball has moved up the rotation a couple times, trying to get a better matchup on blocking, I think.
And here we go. Tokash down the line, it's out of bounds. That's unusual for him. He's been scoring on that play all night long, and he misses that one.
Mike Cummings had his foot on the line where it needs to be. Don't reach outside.
Javier with another good serve takes him out of their offense. They try to back set, a middle shot. It's played up. It's good. Ricky hits it off the block, off the defender, out of bounds.
And the Dons are starting to click right here. They got that momentum the second half of the last game, and they're continuing it on.
2-0. That serves in. He goes back to Tokash again. He goes down the line again. Ricky, oh, what a great play. Oh! Oh, my, they could have called over the net there, but didn't. What a great play by Mike Cummings to dig that ball up. Nonetheless, it's 1-2. Lakers serve. It's in, and Ricky handles it. Justin off the block or through the block. Anyways, it hits the ground.
And
it's
they
in.
Called it good. Another it's good. Point.
It's 3-1 in favor of the Dons as Justin whips up his jumper. He's got some confidence to use it in the fifth game. It's a tip. It's down. And Arnie's not very happy with his defensive play that time.
Got to watch that hitter a little bit more. Scores, he gave it away early.
Score be 3-2 at this point, favor the Dons.
See if the Dons can get a good pass here. Get a point.
Yeah, let's see. I think that the ball would probably go to Ricky at this point. No, it goes to Javi on the backside. He hits it out of bounds. That's 3-3. Now everybody in the gym knows it's going to Ricky.
It's getting pretty obvious.
And they serve Ricky. And he handles it. It's out to Ricky. He hits it. It's a kill. Double block outside. They load their defense up on it. Doesn't matter. He goes right through it.
Yeah, if I was Coach Dovick, I would put Jim Zorn out there instead of their setter. Make Ricky's using him.
Yeah, they need to make an adjustment there, and we're off again. It's outside. Zorn, he's off the block. Great dig. Cummings with a save. Ricky with a radical angle shot. Oh, it's down. It's coming over to us. It's in, but it's out of bounds.
Oh.
And we're almost out of bounds. That's a point for the Dons at 5-3. What a play. Almost a great save by the Lakers.
Great hustle by the Lakers. Almost took out two sportscasters with that shot.
Pancake dig saves it for the Lakers there, and they just couldn't get it over. Went out of bounds by only about a foot, folks.
We're sitting at a great angle to see that shot, though. It was definitely outside the antenna.
And Ryan Tarot serves out in a rally score game. That is one of the seven deadly sins in volleyball.
Cannot have that happen in a rally game.
As they don't return the favor, it's in. Out to Ricky, double block, through the block. No, it's picked up again to Ricky. He's got a cross-court shot. Javi picks it up. Ricky third time off the block and down. That's a blocking kill for the Lakers. It's 5-5, just like that.
When your offense is one-dimensional, it's pretty hard to win a match.
And they're serving Ricky again. It's back to Ricky. He hits down the line this time with a kill. Score be 6-5. Gislin back to serve. He's got to jump him. He's got to make something happen.
He's got to keep it in here.
He goes with it. It's a great serve. It's picked up well, however. Zorn down the line, and Perot tries to dig it up. He misses it.
Right now, the Lakers have two hot hitters, Jim Zorn and Adam Tokosh.
6-6. Ricky doesn't pass it up well. Justin hits it. Nice shot. Awesome shot. Marginal set. Rips it off the block out of bounds. That's what you need.
Hit that ball just outside the block and make him reach for it and get to him.
Ricky serves down the line with a nice one. The ball is set to Tokash on the outside. He goes down the line. Gislin. It misses him. Nope, they call the touch.
Got him in the shoulder.
Call the touch.
Tried to fake out everybody in the stands, but too many people saw it happen.
Score is 7-7. After this play, we will switch sides. That ball is deep. It's handled, however. It's outside to Luna. He goes off the block. Kill. 8-7. Both teams switch side. It's not really a break. We'll start up right away here after they get situated. What a match we have here tonight. It doesn't get much tighter than this.
We'd like to take this time to thank the Channel 6 crew, the IPFW athletic staff, the City of Fort Wayne, and Comcast Cablevision for their contributions to this Channel 6 sports telecast. Special thanks to Pizza Hut at Canterbury for their support in bringing you tonight's telecast of IPFW's men's volleyball.
And the teams are back out on the court. Brian Harris has entered the game as a substitution. We're looking for a major serve here, a little boost. A point or two is all it's gonna take. He's got a nice one going down the line. Totally takes them out of their offense. They go for a weak shot down. Oh, it's a nice hit off a marginal set by Zorn. Gislin doesn't stay home on his defensive position, so he gets burned.
Locked too much line that time. set inside like that, you've got to take them across court.
What a great serve by Brian Harris. The Dons don't capitalize on it, though. And here we go with a nice pass from Ricky. It's outside. Great shot. It's Doug. It's outside. He kind of rolls it. It's Doug out of bounds. Point. And a lead, the first one for the Lakers in the game five. 9-8. The Lakers take the lead.
Andrew Mahaven out there for the Lakers.
And here we are stuck again. Not sure who to set. Who are we going to set? I think we're going to set up something for Javi on the weak side. We're going to call a timeout, though. The Dons take timeout at 9-8. And we will return after these messages.
The men's volleyball team returns to home action on Friday, February 20th.
When the heavens thunder, when the nation calls,
come on!
You can make a difference and be a part of it all.
Find yourself in the Army National Guard, serving one weekend a month and 2 weeks a year, and you'll find an extra paycheck, money for college, and all the adventure you can handle. Call 1-800-GO-GUARD.
In the Army National Guard, you can.
Welcome back to the IPFW Mastodome. The teams are about ready to take the floor here again. It's 9-8 favor of the Mercyhurst Lakers.
The Dons are really missing the firepower of Hector Soto. They're getting very little support out of our left side. That's been the major part of our offense throughout this season.
And here we go. Serve is in. Ricky handles it. It's on target. And there's the pipe set. Huge. Didn't see it coming out of the back row. There it is, our bread and butter tonight. Ricky Soler approaching 50 kills. We serve it in. It's a back set. It's really tight. It's got to be roofed. It is. It's down. Ryan Perron with a huge block to take the lead back. 10-9. That was big.
Yep. That was a big block. Big block. Let's see if they can capitalize now.
Another nice serve. Here we go. It's outside this time, and it's blocked. It's out of bounds.
Chris Gislin went up high, but he didn't penetrate well. Got to reach over and turn that in.
Had him lined up. Didn't turn it. This ball's in. Here we go. It's tipped down. The ball's down. Kill for Chris Gislin at a timely moment. 11-10, the Dons take the lead.
Haven't seen that very often, very much this match. That's a great weapon.
Here he goes. He jumps. He shoots. It's in. Tight. Off the antenna. No block. That's a point. No, it's off the antenna. The Dons take the all-important two-point advantage at 12-10. That is a major advantage when rallies score. And rightfully so, Lakers take timeout at this point. Colin, we have a stressor on our hands here tonight, don't we?
Both teams are really battling. It's going to come down to the wire here. And that's what you want in college volleyball. That makes it all exciting.
Lakers break their huddle. They come back out on the court feeling good about themselves. They've played themselves well in the match tonight, whichever way it goes. Dons, on the other hand, some have played and some haven't.
Coach Stavik from Mercyhurst says they've been playing right with the top teams in the MIVA. He was really confident coming into this match that they play well, and he was right. They are playing well. Dons are being taken to the limit right here.
And they are, as we've got a very important point right here. Luna with a jumper. It's in. It's a nice pass. It's tight. That's a back row block. He's got to call it. He won't call it. Ricky gets a one-on-one. It's a kill anyway. It's a point. Dons! 13-10.
Great job of staying with the play. You can't wait for the referee's whistle. You got to keep playing until it comes. Put that ball down.
Justin with another one. It's in. Another nice pass. Outside. Zorn off the block. Here we go. Gislin outside to Ricky. Swings. He's early. He's down. It's a kill. Down the line. 14-10. Rally score for the Dons.
Match point for the Dons.
The fans are in it. They're trying to get some kind of a mini floor wipe here.
And they
call timeout.
Coach Ball moved up his rotations because Jim Sorn was really taking advantage of Javier and Justin Luna out there being the shorter blockers going over the top of him. Right now he's got to go over Chris Gislin and Ryan Perrott. So
that's a tough order. Gislin is a tad taller than Javi.
He got a piece of that block ball that time. We were able to transition out of it. That's how you win ball games.
Here comes a replay here of the last point. There's the jumper. It's over. It's set outside, and that's what we're talking about. A nice block by our two big men. Outside to Ricky. He goes down the line for the kill.
I think if we get into a transition mode right here, Ricky's going to see that ball. If we can get a dig.
I got to think that ball's going out to Zorn again here. As Justin serves it up, it's in, it's handled, it's outside to Zorn. He swings. It's a kill. The line judge couldn't see it. The top official then makes a call of in.
We got three chances to side out and win this game now. So
all we have to do is have one side out. We will win the match.
That call could be a moot point right there. IPFW gets a good pass.
As Coach Ball is asking how many timeouts he has one more, so he takes it right now. Good strategy move by Coach Ball to break any kind of momentum built by that one play. They have none left. Both teams have used them up. It's playing it out from here.
And we've got three chances right now. All we have to do is side out once in the next three serves. Matches are.
I would think out of these next three plays, if you need them all, I would set every single one of them to Ricky Soler.
I would put good money on that's where the ball's going to go right here.
One out of those three times, he's going to get a kill. He may not get a kill the first time or the second time, but by the third time, you know he's going to get one.
That's right.
So you just totally set him up here. The middle's got to holler a bunch as they go in to try to distract the middle blocker. And you set that ball outside nice and high. It doesn't have to be shooty and flat and low. Just give it up. Give it to him on a platter. Let him rip.
Got Chris Gislin in the front row for our setter, so anything tight, he's going to go up and eat it up too. So.
And here we go. They serve the ball in. Yes, it's in. Ricky handles it. It's outside to Ricky. Here we go. Off the block. It's a kill. Game over. Match over. Dons win. We called it. We knew it was going to happen.
I think everybody in the gym knew where that set was going to go.
And so the Dons win quite a battle tonight. It was over 2 hours long. Great job. Great job by the Dons.
Here we see the replay coming up. A match point for the Dons.
Here it is. The serve is in. It was a tough serve, too. It was deep. Ricky handles it, goes outside nice and high. Ricky goes off the block as they reach out, and that would be the end.
Great job. Great match. Good win for IPFW with Hector Soto being on the bench and all the sickness going on for our team. Great job of pulling together and getting that win.
We'd like to remind you to join us again next Friday evening, February 27th at 7:30 for our next telecast of IPFW Men's Volleyball, when Channel 6 will televise live the match between Long Island University and the IPFW Mastodons. That's next Friday night, 7:30, right here on College Access Channel 6. The telecast of this IPFW sports event is copyrighted and the sole property of the College Access Center and IPFW. Unauthorized duplication, exhibition, retransmission, rebroadcast, or other use of this event without express written consent is strictly prohibited. We hope you've enjoyed our telecast of IPFW sports and hope you'll join us for more exciting action again in the future. We're always glad to have your comments and suggestions, so give us a call at 481-6000 or drop us a card Our address is Channel 6 at IPFW 2101 East Coliseum Boulevard, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46805-1499. Thanks again for joining us this evening. For Colin Leiter, this is Tim Heffron saying goodbye for now.